Good morning and welcome back, children. Today we are continuing the chapter, the assignment-based video recording, based on the first chapter, life process from class 10. Okay, index questions. Eighth one. How is fat digested in our body? Where does this process take place? You know, the fat is digested mainly in the small intestine. The fat is digested mainly in the small intestine. You know, the fat coming from the food, which is you know, acidic food coming from the stomach, get into the small intestine through duodenum, where you can see the bile and pancreas are there. Bile juice contain bile salt. This bile salt break down the large fat globules into small fat globules. Small fat globules that will be readily dissolvable in water. And this small fat globules in water is broken down into glycerol and fatty acids by the pancreatic lipase. So pancreatic lipase contain pancreas contain pancreatic lipase. That pancreatic lipase break down the small fat globules into glycerol and fatty acids. This is happening in the small intestine. So not only that, the complete digestion of the lipids or fat is taking place in the small intestine, other parts of the small intestine. You got this idea? Yes. Now, ninth question. What are the necessary conditions for autotrophic nutrition? What are its byproducts? Necessary condition for autotrophic nutrition, you know, sunlight, carbon dioxide, water, and also the chlorophyll. These are the important things. And in plants and animals, or particularly in plants, during autotrophic nutrition by photosynthesis, the light energy is converted into chemical energy in the granule. Light energy is converted into chemical energy. Light energy, okay, trapped by the chlorophyll molecules. And this will be converted into ATP and NADPH. In the dark reaction, which takes place in the stroma, the carbon dioxide is reduced to carbon dioxide and water by using the ATP and NADPH. And photosynthesis is a very important process, and the byproduct of photosynthesis is oxygen. Oxygen is formed from water by splitting water in the presence of sunlight. Carbon dioxide, you can see hydrogen, oxygen, and electrons are formed. That oxygen become the byproduct. Now, 10th question. What are the differences between aerobic and anaerobic respiration? Name some organisms that are anaerobic mode of use, anaerobic mode of respiration. Okay. Anaerobic respiration is a respiration that takes place in the absence of oxygen, whereas aerobic respiration in the presence of oxygen. Second point, anaerobic respiration mainly takes place in the microscopic organisms like yeast, then bacteria, and also muscle cells of humans. Okay, whereas aerobic respiration takes place in most of the higher organisms, higher plants and animals. Then during aerobic respiration, you know, the glucose is broken down into pyruvate in the cytoplasm. That process is called glycolysis, and the next process, that pyruvate enter the mitochondria and the release of energy takes place in mitochondria. Whereas in anaerobic respiration, the first process is glycolysis, as in aerobic respiration, which takes place in the cytoplasm, and the release of energy from the intermediate compounds takes place in mitochondria. So anaerobic respiration, the energy release takes place in mitochondria. So you have to remember that. Okay. Now, in anaerobic respiration, there is incomplete breakdown of glucose into ethanol or ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide and a little energy. Whereas in aerobic respiration, the glucose is broken down into carbon dioxide, water, and complete energy. Okay. Last one, 11th one. What is the role of saliva in the digestion of food? You know, saliva is a fluid which contains an enzyme. What is enzyme? Salivary amylase or tyrosine. Salivary amylase. Saliva contains an enzyme, salivary amylase or tyrosine. TYRA. This salivary amylase or tyrosine. You can see salivary amylase or tyrosine. You can understand salivary amylase or tyrosine break down the carbohydrate, mainly starch, into simple sugars. So that is the main function of the saliva. Salivary amylase or tyrosine in the saliva convert the starch or any carbohydrate mainly into sugar or simple glucose. Now another function of saliva. Saliva mixed with the food while the teeth masticate or cut. Okay, grind the food. The mixing of saliva make the food soft, and you know, it physically break down the food while masticating the food with the teeth. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much.